Hello students, in this video I'll explain the physical properties of phenol. There are two physical properties I'm going to discuss. First one is known as the solubility in water, whether the phenol is soluble in water or not. Second is the boiling point in the phenols. Let us take the solubility of phenol in water. You know the phenol structure is a benzene ring attached to the OH group. Okay, now when you dissolve in water, water also comes in contact with the molecule. Between hydrogen atom of the phenol molecule and oxygen of the water molecule, there exists a bond interaction called as the hydrogen bonding. Therefore, phenol molecules go away from each other and water molecule comes in between. Therefore, phenol is soluble in water due to the intermolecular hydrogen bonding. So, therefore, phenol is soluble. Phenol is soluble in water. Is soluble in water due to intermolecular hydrogen bonding. Hydrogen bonding with the water molecules due to intermolecular hydrogen bond with water molecules. Okay, right. Second one is about the boiling point. Now when I say boiling point, we are not taking water, pure phenol molecules are there. So let me take a first phenol. There are neighboring phenol molecules. Okay. So there are many molecules in phenol compound. Between the two phenol molecule also, there exists the bonding called as the hydrogen bonding. Hydrogen atom of one molecule interacts with the oxygen of the neighboring molecule and it continues. And this is known as the hydrogen bonding between the two molecules. Hydrogen bonding. And this hydrogen bonding is broken when it dissolves in water. That means these two molecules go away from each other, water molecule comes in between. When they go away from each other and they can form bond with hydrogen water molecule, they dissolve in water. Okay. Now here in this case, there is a hydrogen bond between the two phenol molecules. Now we have to compare the boiling point of the phenol with some other molecule. For example, you have to compare with the hydrocarbons, or we can compare with the haloalkanes. Here question comes, phenols have got higher boiling point compared to that of the hydrocarbons or haloalkanes having a similar or comparable molecular mass. Phenols have higher boiling points compared to hydrocarbons or haloalkanes of similar molar masses. Now what is the reason? Between the two phenol molecules, there is this hydrogen bonding. So between the two molecule, bonding is stronger, interest stronger. But in case of hydrocarbons or haloalkane, there is no hydrogen bonding. Let me take one simplest example of the hydrocarbon to show what kind of bonding exists. Let me take ethane. Ethane is a CH3, ethane. First ethane molecule. Second ethane molecule, CH3. That is a C2H6 it is, right? Between two ethane molecules, there is no hydrogen bonding, but always there exists the weakest intermolecular forces called as the van der Waals attraction or van der Waals forces of attraction. And this van der Waals force of attraction is very, very weak compared to hydrogen bonding. Hydrogen bonding is stronger. To break the bond, little more amount of energy is required. So therefore, boiling point also increases. Phenols have higher boiling point compared to hydrocarbons and haloalkanes of similar molar masses because of the hydrogen bonding, which is stronger compared to the van der Waals force attraction existing between the hydrocarbon and the haloalkanes. Okay, so these are the two physical properties. First one is solubility, second the boiling point. Right, now we shall see some of the in-text questions from the textbook. Okay, now the first question is, write the IUPAC name of this compound. What is the IUPAC of this compound? You can see here, phenolic derivative. There is a function group. The carbon carrying the function group gets carbon number 1, carbon number 2, carbon number 3, carbon number 4, carbon number 5, and carbon number 6. Right? Therefore, what is the name of this compound? Phenol is a main molecule. It's a derivative of phenol. Some extra groups are the methyl. They are on the second carbon and sixth carbon. So it is a 2, 6. Between the numbers, there should be a comma. Then start with the name. There should be hyphen. How many methyl groups are there? 2. Dimethyl. So it should be called as the 2, 6 dimethyl phenol. Okay. Second question. Write the decreasing order of acidic strength of the following compounds. You have studied acidic strength of the phenol. All these are phenols, you can see, right? All these are phenols. You know that whenever electron withdrawing groups are there, acidic character increases. Whenever electron donating groups are there, acidic character decreases. So let me write down the structures of all these compounds. All are phenols. So this is a phenol. But this is a trinitro. 2, 4, 6. Carbon number 2. Carbon number 4. Carbon number 6. This is a trinitro. 3 times nitro group should be there. 3 times nitro group. And you know this one. This is a picric acid. Right? Yeah. Next compound we have got is 3 nitrophenol. We have got phenol molecule. We have got phenol molecule. Phenol molecule. OH is attached. On third carbon atom, nitro is present. Carbon number 1, carbon number 2, carbon number 3. Nitro is present. Okay. Third compound, 3, 5 dinitrophenol. Benzene ring attached to the OH group. Carbon number 1, carbon number 2, carbon number 3. Carbon number 4, carbon number 5. Nitro, NO2 group. NO2 group. And the last one, 4-methylphenol. Benzene ring attached to OH is a phenol. Carbon number 1, carbon number 2, carbon number 3, carbon number 4. Methyl is here. Okay, see the phenol is a derivative. It is all are the phenol derivatives. NO2 group is a electron withdrawing group. CH3 is electron donating group. In the previous video, we have studied acidity of phenol. Whenever electron withdrawing groups are there, acidic character, acidity increases. Whenever electron donating groups are there, acidity decreases. So NO2, NO2, NO2. First three compounds are NO2. So their acidic nature is more compared to which one? Compared to this compound. Right? And this compound is a paracresol. So you have to write down now decreasing order of them. Which is the least acidic? Least acidic is that which contains electron donating group. So let me write in terms of Roman number. Roman number 4 compound is the least acidic. Remaining are more acidic compared to this compound. Now, 3 nitro groups are there. 1 nitro group is there. 2 nitro groups are there. Remember, as the number of electron withdrawing groups increases, acidic character goes on increases. Lesser the number of electron withdrawing group, lesser is the acidic. So, more the nitro group, more the electron withdrawing group, stronger is the acid. So, first one is the stronger acid. Then comes, here 1 nitro group, there are 2 nitro groups. So, we'll go for the third one. then comes second one. Okay, then comes the second one. All these contains nitro group, and this contains the methyl group. Electron withdrawing group, if it is there, stronger is the acid. Here there are three nitro groups. There are three nitro groups, two nitro groups, one nitro group. Okay, so these numbers are represented for nitro groups, 3, 2, 1. As the number of electron withdrawing group decreases, acidic character also decreases. Then methyl, again electron donating group, its acidic character is still less than that of the second compound. Okay, so this is the order, right? We'll move on to the next question. Question number 3. A statement has been given. Phenol reacts with the concentrated sulfuric acid to give phenol 2,4 disulfonic acid. Again reacts with the concentrated nitric acid to give 2,4,6 trinitrophenol. Write the equation involved. Okay, so we have to start with the phenol, right? We have to start with the phenol. So let me write the phenol structure. Benzene ring attached to the OH. Then they are given concentrated sulfuric acid. What is the use of sulfuric acid? Sulfonation you have to carry out. Sulfonation we have to carry out. Now sulfonation will bring SO3H group to the benzene. Okay, so 2,4 benzene ring attached to the OH. With respect to phenol, second carbon atom, third carbon atom, fourth disulfonic acid, two times SO3H group. Okay, then followed by concentrated nitric acid, concentrated H2SO4. Now what will happen? Finally we get to 2,4,6 trinitrophenol. So benzene ring attached to the OH, second carbon atom, fourth carbon atom, and the sixth carbon atom, we get nitro group, 2,4,6 trinitrophenol, which is also called as the picric acid, correct? Which is also known as the picric acid, correct? Now where will these group go now? Sulfonic acid. So what happens is that this nitric acid, supposed to be nitric acid, the concentrated nitric acid acts as the oxidizing agent. It oxidizes sulfonic acid group, sulfur dioxide. Okay, it getting oxidized to give sulfur dioxide gas and goes out. Okay, so this is the product obtained, right? Yeah, question number 3 is done. We'll go for question number 4. Write the structures of major products. Okay, they are given products expected from the following reaction. First one is mononitration of 3-methyl phenol. Nitration means you introduce NO2 group. How many NO2 group? Single, only one, mono, which means there can be mononitration, dinitration, trinitration. Right? So they want now only mononitration of 3-methylphenol. So let me write this structure. Benzene ring attached to the OH. Okay? Phenol, 3-methyl, 1, 2, 1, 2, and 3. 3-methyl. With the presence of concentrated nitric acid. You know that you have studied in phenol chapter. Benzene ring attached to the OH, lone pair and oxygen is involved in the resonance. Therefore, we expect to ortho and para product, because the OH group is ortho para directing group. So I can expect here, this is the ortho position. I can expect here, this is the ortho position or para position. Okay. Now, if there is a possibility of writing only one nitro group at the ortho position, which one you will select? Now, if the NO2 groups comes here, then OH is there, CH is there. there will be overcrowding of the atom. Suppose NO2 group comes to this ortho position, then there is an overcrowding of OH NO2 CH3. Therefore, it leads to instability of the product. The compound is not stable. So I expect NO2 group come to this ortho position easily. So we'll write ortho here. Okay, so we are going to write now benzene ring attached to the OH. Okay, then here it is not there. Here it is a CH3, and then here it is a NO2 group. This is one possibility. What is the second possibility? Second possibility is that we can expect a para product. Okay, we expect the para product. Benzene ring attached to the OH. Then a CH3. Then I'll write here NO2 group. Okay, almost equal proportions can be formed. Okay, so mononitration. Moreover, CH3 is a what? Alkyl group, electron donating group. With respect to CH3, which is electron donating group, it can also give product at ortho and para position. So with respect to CH3 now, I can expect the product at ortho. This is ortho. This is also ortho. With respect to CH3, ortho. But here cannot come. Correct? But here it can come. So here the possibility. This is the possibility. With respect to CH3, para is also possible. So ortho, meta, para. Possible. Okay? So both the groups will influence the incoming NO2 group. Either to the ortho position or to the para position. So these are almost in equal amounts are formed. Okay? Right? So which is a minor product? Suppose there is a minor product, we can expect NO2 group here, but that is not that much stable. It can be very trace amount formed. Okay? Clear? Yeah. We'll move on to the next question. The next question is dinitration of 3-methylphenol. Same compound, but now we have to carry out what? Nitration. Okay, so benzene ring attached to the OH. Carbon number 1, carbon number 2, carbon number 3. Right? Now carry out nitration on this. Concentrated nitric acid. Dinitration. Now introduce the 2 NO2 group. Where will you introduce? So let me write the structure first. Okay, the given molecule. This is the ortho. Okay. Ortho possibility. This ortho possibility is very, very less because OH, NO2, CH3 are very close to each other. There will be overcrowding of the atoms or steric hindrance. We call it steric hindrance. Not possible. Can come here. This ortho possible. With respect to OH, para is also possible. Yes. So we can get dinitro. Dinitro is possible. Or with respect to CH3, with respect to ortho, possible, para, possible. So this is a dinitro compound which can be formed. Okay, right? Yeah. Next one, we'll go for mononitration of phenyl ethanoate. What is phenyl? Phenyl is benzene. Benzene, phenyl, aryl are one and the same. Ethanoate. Okay, this is one type of ester. It is ester. Let me write down the carboxylic acid, HCOOH. This is the formic acid. Common name is formic acid. Its IUPAC name is, how many carbon atoms are there? Only one carbon atom, meth, single carbon atom, meth, methanoic acid. This is a methanoic acid. Methanoic acid. Okay. Let me go for acetic acid, CH3COH, acetic acid. You know that this is called as the vinegar. Dilute solution of acetic acid is known as the vinegar, right? This is the acetic acid, okay? Or its IUPAC name is, how many carbon atoms are there? 2 carbon, ethanoic acid, okay? Now, when I remove this hydrogen, becomes formate. It becomes formate. If I remove this hydrogen, it becomes acetate. Remember, remove hydrogen, formate. Remove hydrogen, acetate. Or with respect to IUPAC name, remove hydrogen, methanoate. Remove hydrogen, ethanoate. Which ethanoate is given? Phenyl. That means I should write down, okay, phenyl ring attached to CH3C double bond O, then O, like this. This is a CH3CO, OH. H is replaced by the phenyl group. So it is known as the phenyl ethanoate. Phenyl ethanoate. Okay? Right? Clear? Now, you have to introduce the nitro group. Usually nitro group, nitration, electrophilic substitution take place on the benzene ring. See here. Lone pairs are there on the oxygen. Attach the benzene. Involve the resonance. So, it is an electron donating group. Remember, oxygen attached to benzene electron donating group. That means it can give either ortho position or the para position. Now we are supposed to write down only one major product. We can't write both. Okay. So see here, nitro group, when it comes here, it is very closer to OCOCH3. Little bulkier group is there. Larger group is there. Larger group will not allow the NO2 group to come to the ortho position easily. Therefore, ortho nitro compounds are minor products. Therefore, NO2 group can directly easily go to the para position. So, para will be the major product. Okay. So, O, CO, CH3, then to the para position NO2 group. So, this is the major product form. Right. So, in this video, you have studied the solubility of phenol in water, then boiling points of phenols, then we have solved some in-text problems. Okay. So we are done with the phenol topic. In the next video, I'll explain alcohol chapter. Okay. Thank you for watching. And those who are not subscribed RD Chemistry, please do subscribe, like the videos, share the videos. Thank you.